Hi, I'm Will Harris-Braun from Holo, and this is how to whitelist in the Holo ICO. First, let's talk about the things you'll need before you start the whitelisting process. You'll need a passport or another identifying document. So passports work the best. Pretty much any country, a passport will work for verification, but also ID cards, residence permits, driver's licenses can work from certain countries also. If you have a passport, please use a passport. You'll need a webcam or a mobile device. Your computer either needs to have a webcam or you need to be able to use a smartphone or another device that can download mobile apps to use mobile verification. And you'll need an ETH address. You'll need to have already set up an Ethereum account with an address. So, first things first, let's go to our verify site, verify.holo.host. And you'll see, you should see this page, and you click sign up, because you'll be starting an entirely new account. And I will put in my email, will@holo.host. And I'll create a new password. Make sure it's a strong password and that it's unique from all your other passwords. So here's my password, and I'll type it in again. And I'll click sign up. At this point, you'll get an email to the email address you entered to confirm your email account. So here's my email. And here's the email I received, and that's what it will look like. Click this link to activate your account. And there we go. Your email address has been successfully confirmed. And now we'll log in again with the same credentials we just used. And I'm going to click Remember Me, just because I don't want to have to log in over and over again. And this is my personal computer, so that's not going to be a security issue. And here we go. So the first step is to agree to the terms and conditions, and you can click this link and you'll find them here. There they are. So I've read and agreed to the terms and conditions and confirm. And now we'll enter our personal information. So I'm using a passport for my verification, so I'm going to select passport. And for document number, I'm going to open up my passport. I'm going to look at the passport number on it. And it's important that you type this in exactly as it shows up on your passport. And same with your names. So this will be the names that show exactly as they show up on your passport. So my given names, that's my middle and first, and that's my first and middle name. So I'll put in William, which is my first name, and my middle name. And last names, I'll put in my last names as it appears on my document. This is important because in reality, my last name is Harris-Braun, like this. But on my passport, it doesn't have the hyphen, it has a space instead. So I'm going to put in what it shows on my passport, not what my actual legal name is. And I'll put in the country that my passport is from. That is Ecuador. And I'll click save.